take you out to Ted Ryan now. Here's the winning jockey in Darren Murphy.
Thank you, Alan. Yes, the winning rider, Darren Murphy, with Dapper's Express. Well, that was a pretty impressive performance, Darren. A little bit of trouble early, but you got him out at the right time.
It was a little bit tight early, Ted. But he sort of overcome. He wasn't in any great difficulty. He sort of got a nice run in the race, and when I brought him out, he went the line nice under Hanson Hill's riding.
It was only his second run in about 7 months. Was he out injured or something, Darren, or what?
No, he's been a slow maturing horse, and my boss, Ian Saunders, has given him every chance he needs to develop into the horse he is now. And, he's a great trainer, Ian. His record proves that, and he's only have to see his horse in the mountain yard, and they're all presented to magnificent condition, and that's the horse race today.
A lot of people might know he beat Nosy Knight at his first start too, so that was a pretty impressive performance because he's gone on.
He beat Nosy Knight at about his third or fourth start. That day, Nosy Knight was a bit unlucky to get beat, but still the form was good. Yeah.
Thank you, Darren, very much. Back to you, Bezza.
Thanks very much, Teddy. Well, interesting, the betting so far here on the Bendigo Cup in the wind pool is more than 132,000 on the tote here in Victoria. And the tote favourite at the moment is number 4, Abstraction, showing $1.65. Abstraction to be ridden by Darren Gutchie. The second favourite in the cup is number 16, Lord Palmerston, to be ridden by Ricky McLeish at $3.45. And the third, the best back runners on the TAB so far is number 17, the Hurdler Sharpaz, ridden by Michael Clark. It's into $3.65. So, Kathy, can Sharpaz cause a bit of an upset?
Yeah, well, Sharpaz's flat form, as I said to Clem, is hard to fault. He's never been beaten on the flat, and he's an improving horse.
Well, it'll be interesting to see how Sharpaz goes in the cup.